Okay!
As the wicked Dr. Hayward on All My Children, our first guest has blackmailed nearly everyone in Pine Valley, accidentally poured a sex drug into a punch bowl at a party. I'm not sure why we weren't at that party.
I hear ya.
And he accidentally gave Adam Chandler a potentially lethal injection.
In other words, he's the kind of man that women love to hate. Please welcome Vincent Irizarry.
Hey. Hey guys.
So David, welcome.
Oh, yes,
I
David.
Did it again. Do you notice
Hi,
that
yellow
I've done
ribbon?
Yes.
I like that. I'm in the back there, and half of the guys in the crew, they're going, I don't even know that song. It's like, it makes you feel so old.
Really?
Oh,
and I said, it was right there with Knock Three Times on the Window, if you are.
Oh,
the,
yeah!
The ceiling, if you And they're like, I never heard that song either.
Oh, they're famous.
You guys remember those songs.
Yeah, if it's not in sync back there, they don't know it.
Yes. Oh!
Yeah, they're going to beat me up after
yeah,
I go backstage.
Right. Yeah, they are.
So David, at All My Children, not the kind of the bad guy, but the bad guy with the heart.
Right. Well, I'm very proud of my character's nefarious deeds. Do you like it? Do you like that? Do you like the character? You know what I love about this character? It's been so exciting to play him for the last 5 years. I just passed my fifth year, actually,
wow.
just a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
So,
congratulations.
Yeah, that's great. Which, especially, was only supposed to be for 3 months, so I'm very happy. It's been a great run. What I love about this character is that they allow me the opportunity to play so many different facets of his nature. You know, he is a villain, but at the same time, he has compassion, he has sensitivity, he's a brilliant, world-renowned cardiologist, right? That's why they can't keep him in jail. Whenever anything happens on the show, they need to take him out of jail so he can, like, do a heart transplant, which he did do.
Thank goodness.
So you can't do that from behind bars, so.
Now, do the fans like you in general? Are they positive toward you?
Very much so. In the beginning, it wasn't as much that way. They hated my character, and they just hated to hate him. They didn't love to hate him.
Well, because in the beginning, you were a three-month character, in all fairness, so they didn't want to redeem you, the writers. They wrote you as just the bad guy.
And what happened was that they didn't have a history for the character, so there was no justification for the way that he was. He was just basically, after a period of time, he really started becoming more of a nuisance, you know, in the lives of these characters, and you could understand why the audience wouldn't like him. So I went to the producers at one time, this is when they brought me back after the 3 months, and I said, we have to build a life for this character. We have to build a history. Hopefully you'll bring on another character that knows this person from when he was younger, that knows how to, what makes him tick. And they did. They came up with a wonderful story. They brought on Marge Doucet as my mother at the time. She did a fabulous job, didn't she?
Right.
It was so great. My introduction, the audience introduction to Marge as my mother, they didn't know who she was. She was at a party at Erica's house, at Erica's party, and she has a heart attack. And I'm standing over her in the parking lot, and Erica's like, help her, help her. I'm a cardiologist. I'm looking at her with this look of hatred, and I literally step over her in the parking lot and walk away.
Oh,
and the audience is like, who is this woman? Who is this woman? Then they find out it's my mother.
Right.
My father committed suicide at her urging, and I hated her ever since. So that justified why I was the way that I was.
Really
it was a fantastic backstory. They did a great job.
Yeah.
So.
You have a very unique fan club, which I think is interesting to mention.
Fovey. Some of them are here, actually.
Yeah.
Over here.
Yeah,
I just noticed that when I came out.
So you recognize them?
Yes, I recognize them.
Really?
They're so devoted. It's friends of Vincent Irizarry is Fovey. What happened over the years, 20 years, people have asked me if I would like to have a fan club, and I've always said no. I felt uncomfortable. It feels strange having people come together to exalt you. You know, I'm like, it's okay. It's all right. Thank you.
I don't think it seems so strange.
You like that? I'm sure Harry does his share, honey. He lifts you up often. But what's interesting that they came to me, these women became friends on the internet, on the David site, the message boards over the years where ABC had a David site. They became friends and started meeting each other at different personal appearances around the country. They came to me and they said, what if we do something different? If we raise awareness for certain charitable organizations that you may be a part of, we can raise funds through charity, you know, functions. And also even raise even physical support, volunteer support. And I said, well, that's something different. Let's try that. Let's give it a shot. And in 1 year, they came up with the idea of doing an eBay auction with All My Children memorabilia. And I said, let's see what happens. It was 1 week we did it. I got all the people from the show to sign all this memorabilia, which they provided for me, the women from Fovey. And I also got a few lunches donated from some of the actors. And we raised, in 1 week on eBay, $25,000 for charity.
Terrific.
That was the first time. That was the first time. Now, we did it again 2 years later. We did it recently. All in total, we raised recently close to $30,000 for Habitat for Humanity. We're hoping to sponsor an entire house for Habitat. And on top of that, all in total, we've raised close to $70,000
wow,
in 3 years.
That's terrific.
So I'm like, this is better than I ever could have imagined.
Yeah, that must feel really good.
Yeah, it's fantastic. It's,
now,
it's
have your fans followed you? Because you were you had a huge fan base playing Lou Jack on right. Guiding Light. Have they followed you from Guiding Light to?
A lot of them have. Yeah. It's interesting because when you do these shows, you're on a network and people are very faithful to that network.
Right.
You know, and as I was on Guiding Light, that was CBS. But and you can be in certain regions in the country where CBS or NBC or ABC isn't that popular and people don't know you, but I've been on Guiding Light on CBS, I was on Santa Barbara on NBC, and now I'm on ABC, All My Children, so it's like I have no place to hide now. But it's a good thing. I mean, that's the truth. That's the business that we've chosen for ourselves, and if people aren't recognizing you, then there's a problem, really. You
know? Are there things from each character that you kind of try and say, wow, that really worked, and try and build into the next character, or do you start all over from scratch?
Well, first of all, you do start with yourself whenever you're creating a character. You have to have some sensitivity, some empathy for the motives of the character. Even for a character that's like David, I mean, he's a villain, but even a villain justifies their actions.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
They believe that what they're doing is for a purpose, and they need to do it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I can't divorce myself from the creative process. I can't do that. But I do try to certainly create each character as unique from the other. And gotcha. And I think that if you hold up all three characters from each of these shows, you would see that they're very different.
Because obviously you were very different. I mean, when you started as Lou Jack,
right.
That was your first daytime role.
That's right.
Previously to that, you were...
I was a kid. I was doing theater in New York at the time, and I was living in a rooming house in New York City. Sharing a kitchen and a bathroom with six other rooms in the village.
Wow.
And I loved it. It was great. But I had a piano in that room, my bookshelf, my bed, you know, and a ceiling fan that I put up that I was so bad at it. The thing looked like it would fall on me at any moment because it was always wobbling. That people go, is this okay? It's hanging from the wire, you know? and people would come to interview me there, and I'd have to give them a roll of toilet paper to go use the bathroom down the hall. And they'd go, this is interesting. And this guy's like a national TV star on a daytime show. But it was very different for me at that time.
Yeah.
I was working at Joe Allen's restaurant when I got the job on Guiding Light. I had just started the job. It was my first day that I was going to have my own station, and I get a call from my agent saying that you got the part on Guiding Light. But that was only supposed to be for 2 days' work.
Really?
Yeah.
So you were able to turn that one into a long-term
Yeah,
as well.
So the daytime has been very, very good to me.
Well, we want to hear all about your family and your personal life when we come back. Guys, don't go away. We'll come right back.
Coming up next, more with Vincent Irizarry.
Anna, come on, look at her. I mean, she's so small, and she's been through so much already. She's my first child, and chances are she's going to be my last. I will not subject her to the pain and trauma of unnecessary surgery.
We're back with Vincent Irizarry.
And that's your new baby, adorable baby on the show.
And she coos and does everything on cue. It's amazing.
Really?
Even when she just came out of the womb, she was just like, she was brilliant. And she couldn't take her eyes off me. I was like, oh my gosh, this baby. She's like,
she's a charmer from the womb.
Oh, she was. She was so charming.
And speaking of babies, speaking of children, you have three now.
I have three kids. Yeah, I have three kids.
Tell us.
I have a 13-year-old, Sienna. She just turned 13, March 6th.
Wow.
And I have Aria is 5 years old, and Elias, who is 16 months old, my son Elias.
Oh.
And he just took his first steps?
Well, yeah, he took his first steps a week before his first birthday at Super Soap Weekend down in Florida. When we were there, we were in a place called the Hideaway Lounge. It's a green room, basically, for all the actors in between all the events that we're doing. And my son, all of a sudden, starts walking from one of us to somebody who was, like, five steps away. And we're like, he's walking. And then he walks, like, seven steps. And then before we know it, literally, within a two-minute period, he's taking 14, 15 steps around the room.
That's great.
And then he gets there, and he's applauding himself. It was so funny. Like, all the ABC execs are like, this is his first time walking? Look at this kid. He's going to start, like, collecting some of the cups and stuff.
What's it like having a son?
Oh, it's fantastic. You know, it's an interesting thing because I wanted daughters first. Mm-hmm. I did want a daughter first. Most men say, I want a son. I didn't feel like I was ready for a son yet. I in a way, at the time, I felt like I need to grow up a little bit because I was afraid that I was going to be, a son would push buttons in me like I did to my father.
True.
And then I wasn't ready to see my father come out of me yet, you know? I wanted to be male person yet. I love my father, and I'm happy to have my father be a part of me. I just wasn't ready for that yet. I feel as if I've known him my whole life. It's almost like this sort of symbiosis that is indescribable. I don't know.
Do you take a ton? I know you're also a very accomplished photographer. Do you take like a ton of pictures
and document
the whole thing?
Yeah, we have photographs of him like crazy, and all of my kids. I love photography, that's true, and I'd love being able to take that and use that in a creative way. And,
do you remember your first photo you've ever taken?
Yeah, it's actually what it was I took one of the first photographs. I took a hubcap from an old like 57 Chevy, which was the dome chromed hubcaps.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, there was like domed all the way around, and I laid it on a parking lot, in the parking lot floor, and I put my legs on either side of it, and because of the distorted perspective from the dome coming up, there were a beautiful cloudy day, and I took a photograph into the hubcap, and I had bell bottoms because it was in the 70s. I'm dating myself again. I had my bell bottoms on both sides of the hubcap with my feet extending because it was being distorted, and I had this wild hair. I looked like Einstein with the camera there, and it's actually a really great. And I had all the clouds behind it. It came out beautiful. It was a really great shot. And so that was the first one of the first pictures I took.
Well, that's just one of your many talents. You've also you're a tenor.
I started studying voice about 7 years ago, even though I had been singing for years. I played Paul McCartney on stage back in the early 80s and other musical roles that I had done. I did something at the Public Theater called The Death of Von Richthofen. But I started really pursuing singing in a more professional way, a more legit way, by studying light classical, so like Andrea Bocelli and other classical, and even operatic. So.
And you've performed at Carnegie Hall?
I performed at Carnegie Hall, at Weill Recital Hall at Carnegie Hall. I performed there. I performed with the Orchestra de Lyon in Lyon, France, and I've done other things. It's been about a year since I've been singing, though. Once my son was born, and last year was such an intense schedule on the show, and I do something in my community regarding churches that I'm involved in. I was stretched to the max. There was no time left, and I needed to be able to spend time with my newborn son and my family as well. So
you also are busy doing impressions for your son. That's how you talk to him? You have long, in-depth discussions doing characters, right?
Sometimes I do different
characters. Well, obviously not all the time.
I do, but it's always been with my daughter. My daughters, I've done, one daughter, she loves to hear Goofy and, oh, hey, how you doing, kids? Oh, it's Goofy here. She's always asked me, come on, talk to me. I'm going to talk to Goofy.
Oh, they love that, don't they? They love those voices.
Yeah. And Paul McCartney, which I did on the show, in that play. Oh, Paul McCartney is interesting because he sounds like he has a head cold all the time, and he's always bouncing his head around like this. Hello, talking like that. Now, John Lennon has a nasally voice tonight.
Oh,
I hope we pass the audition.
Funny. Yeah.
Thank you.
That's very funny.
Well, Vincent, thank you very much for joining us today.
This is great, man.
We'd love for you to come back and sing for us in West Piano or something. Don't go away.